Hey guys, this is Tim from Tim's Electronics Lab and welcome back to a new video. Well, this is a little bit of an update video regarding the previous video of mine, the video where I connect my Siglent oscilloscope to the FY6900 AWG. I tried out the boat pulp function, but the results looked a little bit weird. The graphs were all over the place and it didn't make sense, the outputs. So I did some research and it turned out that I was doing it completely wrong. You know, these things happen when you're new to the field. Today we're going to try again. Well, of course, we've got the humbug and we've got the setup that we had in a previous video. But you now need three BNC to BNCs. Now, preferably with a 50 ohm termination load between there. But I don't have that. So we'll do it without a termination load today. Now, this might not be the most optimal way of doing this, but hey, I get some results. So, and I think my oscilloscope has a 50 ohms termination load built in, but I'm not sure. So, yeah, well, let's switch to the oscilloscope, shall we? So we're at the oscilloscope, but let me turn it on. And we've got the humbug over here. Now, what I did previously, I just connected the channel 1 output of the AWG to the humbug and the output of the humbug to my scope. Now, I already noted that during the boat plotting, channel 2 was also shown. I was like, why is channel 2 shown? That doesn't make sense, since, yeah, you only have one channel, I thought. Well, turned out to be wrong. If we go to boat plot and then config, then set channels, you can see DU2 input channel 1. Now DU2 stands for device under test, so it's expecting the input for the device under test to also be at channel 1 of your oscilloscope. So to fix that, I connected a BNC to BNC from channel 1 of my AWG to channel 1 of my oscilloscope. As you can see right here, it's a little bit of a mess. Here's the channel 1, and the U2 output is set to channel 2. So that's this one. So this one needs to be at the output of the device under test. So just connect it like this. Now, I'm not sure if it's the ESP that's behind this AWG or that it's the actual oscilloscope or that's the sync function over here on the AWG. I'm not really sure what that does, by the way, but when you start boat plotting, channel 1 and channel 2 both have the same frequency values. So that's good because you can use channel 1 to go to channel 1 of your oscilloscope and channel 2 to connect to the output of this little device, the device under test. And then you can use channel 2 of your AWG to connect it to the input of the device under test. Now, this is a passive device, so it doesn't really have an input or an output. It's basically, just pass through. So, channel 1 of your scope goes to channel 1 of your AWG, and channel 2 of your scope goes to the output of your device under test, and channel 2 of your AWG goes to the input of the device under test. Now, this is all set. Channel gain I set to auto. You can configure these things, maybe. Now, when you start the boat plot, now let me show my sweep. So 260 Hz is the sender, span of 500 Hz and 300 points. Now this will take a while. The more points you'll set, the more commands the oscilloscope is going to send to your AWG. So the more frequency steps will be used to measure the device accurately. It's a little bit of a shame that we can't go down, because I'm basically interested in a sender of around 100 Hz and a span of around 200 Hz. But hey, it is what it is. It's already pretty nice that this option is available. for free. So let's start it. And as you can see, when we take a look at the AWG, you can see that, there you go, 11 Hertz, and it also says 11 Hertz down there. This is a square, and this is a sine. Now I'm not sure if it does that automatically. I think it does, because I think if you try to change it, no. Oh, that's a little bit of a shame. I think this also needs a sine wave. So the waveforms don't get matched. So we need to start it again. Now it's running. Yeah, there you go. So I'm expecting a better result right now. I already did a boat plot of this device, but the result was really weird. It had like a massive slope at the beginning, and then all of a sudden it was all over the place. So I think that these results will be a lot better. So let's wait for it to finish. It's completed, the boat plot is done, and I think this is because of the high Z impedance that we set. The amplitude is rather high, so but there's a, you can't zoom in, that's a little bit of a shame. There's a definite bottom side regarding the amplitude. I mean, it starts at 1.85 and it ends at around 8, so the device is definitely doing something at around 40 Hertz and lower frequencies. You can also see that in the phase. So let's try and set the stimulus high Z, set it back to 50 ohms. And let's do a little bit less points, because it takes around 15 minutes to do this. Quite a time consuming process. So let's start it again. So it didn't make a whole lot of a difference. As you can see, the amplitude is still around 8 dB at the max frequency. But the begin frequencies are really getting suppressed over here. So that's the idea. Now, sometimes you have a scope that doesn't have a boat plot function, but you still want to create a frequency analysis graph based on the amplitude. Well, you can do that. Most modern scopes have, let me get out of this menu. Yeah, exactly. Most modern scopes have an FFT function. So what you do is, basically you don't need channel 1 as an input. You can just use channel 2, as that's already connected. I'll do it for easy setup over here. So you still need your AWG connected to either channel 1 or channel 2. I'm going to switch it to channel 1 since channel 2 doesn't have the ability to perform a frequency sweep. Maybe I've not discovered it yet, but yeah. So channel 2 over here. This is still the output. Let's remove this one. And disable channel 1. Channel 2. Oh, channel 2 is coupled AC. So let's make that DC. Yeah, cool. So FFT config. Well, you can configure everything over here. You need to set the mode to max hold. That will hold the maximum value. So horizontal, center, 50 kilohertz. Now you can adjust this. You can go really low. But yeah, this is not what you want. 10 hertz per division. I think 100 hertz per division is fine. And you can go all the way down. There you go, I can just type it into 500 hertz. There you go. And now you've got 1 hertz at the left and 1 kilohertz at the right. Now, obviously you can see it's already running, but this is running at a fixed frequency of 464. If you're able to see right here. So that's not what we want. To basically use this function, go to sweep, and at start enter 0 hertz, and at the end, well, I'm going to enter 500 hertz. The time, if you perform a slow sweep, you'll have better results. If you perform a fast sweep, you need to let it sweep a couple of times to get a good max hold plot. And I'm going to decrease it to 20 seconds. You can do back and forth sweep. You can also do forward sweep. You can also do backward sweep. It doesn't really matter as long as you've got that, where is it? That config, that max hold mode on. So this is set. Show peaks, that might be useful because you can view where the peaks are. As you can see, peak 1, 465 hertz. You can see the amplitude. You can also sort it by frequency or by amplitude. So now if we press OK, you can see that the thing changed. And not a whole lot happens. It needs to trigger on channel 2. If we go back, ignore this, and if we now start it, we should see something happen over here. External load, we can set this at 0. Oh, 1 ohms. Sure. We can see it rising. Now we can increase the or decrease it to only 500 hertz. And you can really see it building up over there. So let's change it to a little bit of a bigger setting. That's the horizontal. I think this should be set at 50. And then yeah, then we have the full range. So we've got a total of 100 kilohertz. Vertical. Yeah, we can move that a little bit. Cool. And now we can increase the frequency. So let's make it, what should we do, 100 kilohertz. So we should increase the time it takes to perform the sweep as well. Let me set it to 20 seconds. There you go, that's a little bit better. So it's wobbling a lot, and we should see that when it sweeps again, it's about now, yeah, it will level out because of the max hold. It will hold the maximum value at that point. Now this happens because we've set a relatively low frequency sweep time, and we need to let it run a couple of times in order for the graph to stabilize. So if you want to stabilize the thing at the first run, you'll need to set a high sweep time, so there will be more points per time delta. You guys can see it really flattened out. Quite surprising, because this should suppress various signals, but yeah, it's giving us a flat line. Maybe a lower frequency will do. So let me first show you the effects of a high sweep time. So let's set a 120 second sweep time, so that's 2 minutes. There you go. Really slow sweep time. And it didn't start at 0 hertz, so that's why it starts over there. And as you can see, the flat line is immediately being given because there are a lot more frequency steps that the AWG will take. And yeah, a lot more frequency steps will enter the oscilloscope's input FFT signal math coprocessor thing. Because there's a separate coprocessor for FFT in this thing. Pretty cool. That's pretty cool. As you can see, it gives a flat line, and we can decrease the scale. Ooh. And move it up a little. So it's still centered. Now I'm not sure if this is because I'm fiddling around with the thing. Could be. And it starts over again, and as you can see, it will fill in that gap, and it will fill in all across the gap that's there. So we've got one nice line when it finishes, like that. And if we let this run for a couple of sweeps, I'm expecting the end to also clean up nicely. As you can see, we're a couple of runs further, and well, it's almost a flat line. So let me, oh, that went the wrong side. So it's still doing a sweep. And if we let it run a couple of times, you can see that even the tiny things go up. So with this function, with the FFT function, you're able to perform accurate frequency analysis without the boat plot functionality. It's still basically a boat plot, but without the phase. You can enable the phase, but I'm not sure if you can enable the phase in such a graph. So I've got a couple of other things that I'd like to give a try. Well, basically inductors. So let's put them in between the FFT. Or maybe I'll use both. Maybe I'll do both, just for fun. I'm going to do the boat plot first. So let's set it up like it was. I'm going to use the alligator clips. Clip one end onto the input. And one end we're going to connect it to the input of the oscilloscope, like so. We're going to just tie the grounds together, and well, with all those wires sticking around, we don't need the sweep functionality anymore. We are going to disable the math, enable channel one again, boat plot, config, set sweep. Yeah, I can't go down, that's a shame. Alright, well, just let it run. Oh. Yeah, this is very annoying, because if you forget to enable channel 2, it will change the frequency, but it won't output actually anything, so I'm going to take a look at how I can fix that in the source code of the ESP that's at the back of this AWG, because it's very annoying. So let's start it again and wait for the results. So So I just noticed that the amplitude of the sine wave is set to 5 volts and not to 3 or to 2 volts, as we can see over here. So yeah, this code really needs a couple of fixes. So let's stop the boat plot and change the amplitude to 2 volts. Alright, now nothing really happened, but maybe something will happen right now. I'm not expecting anything to happen, because it's basically the same but with a lower amplitude. Oh wow, the amplitude has really decreased. I wasn't expecting that. So, well, let's try the FFT right now, because this will just give us a straight line. Channel 2 is still the input. And let's enable sweep again from 0 Hz to 100 kHz. Let's get it started. Wow, it's got a lot of resonant frequencies. Wow. It's at 30 kilohertz. And it's got resonant frequencies at 50, 60. This is the real frequency over here. Wow. I also think that the two peaks, Max Hall's still on. Still on. So with this tool, with the FFT, you are still able to see things that you weren't able to see with boat plot, namely the resonance frequency. So this one has a lot of resonance frequencies, and we can take a closer look by decreasing the end frequency, setting it to 100 Hz for example, like so. Press OK. Now go to your horizontal and decrease the time base. And with this tool you can easily locate various resonance frequencies of various components. So I'm just going to stop this and we're going to attach a different one to see how this one behaves. I'm going to enable the math function. It should clear the memory. So as you can see, something is happening over there, and it might be because of the crude connection to the thing, because there are various contacts exposed and all that stuff, and there's no 50 ohms termination resistor, but it's still doing something. Now I'm going to decrease the sweep time to 5 seconds. Now this one doesn't really resonate anywhere, and we can manually do this of course by just setting the frequency whilst the FFT functionality is active. Oh, there you go. Well, that's basically where the frequency is right now. So that's good.
Cool. So this one doesn't really have any other frequencies. Well, it probably does, but not in the scale that we've set it up for. So let's move on to the last one, the tiny one. And let's use the sweep functionality again. And then we'll disable FFT. Ooh, this one does. Or doesn't it? And it will flatten out. Now the resonant frequencies are not really measurable since this one is minus 60 dB volts. So that's really low. That's really low. So we can't see any resonant frequencies over here. Let's increase the end frequency to 1 kHz. Yeah, I think that's because it just skips various other frequencies. It should all flatten out. I've set the sweeping time to 5 seconds, so yeah. There you go. So this is how you analyze various things with your oscilloscope, your AWG, and either boat plot or FFT. If you like this video, please leave me a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye! Hey guys, this is Tim. I hope you liked that video. If you want to see more, please make sure to subscribe. You can also share the video with your friends and hit that like button. I'll see you in the next one.